My dear brothers and sisters in Christ Jesus, welcome to the Lectio Divina of the 29th Sunday of the year. This day is significant for us as we are inaugurating the Synod 2021-2023 in our dioceses. The theme of today's reflection is Communion, Participation and Mission. These three words are the tagline of the Synod. Today we are inaugurating the 16th Ordinary Synod. In our church history, we see three types of synods: ordinary synods, extraordinary synods, and special synods. The present synod on synodality falls into the category of ordinary synod. This is named as Synod 2021-2023, Synod on Synodality. The Holy Father tells that this synod is for a synodal church, which is characterized by communion, participation, and mission. The Holy Father inaugurated the synod on 10th October 2021. We in our dioceses inaugurated today, that is on 17th October 2021. This synod runs through three phases: the diocesan phase, the continental phase, the universal phase. The diocesan phase ends in April 2022. Continental phase and universal phase follow later. In the context of the synod, let us try to understand the readings of the day. The first reading is taken from Isaiah 53:10 and 11. This passage is part of the fourth servant song that begins in Isaiah 52:13. And ends in 53:12. This theme is about suffering servant. Nobody has ever come to the conclusion who the suffering servant is. Some people say it refers to the people of Israel. Some people say it has a referential context of Messiah. Some say it might refer to a king. We are not sure what or who the suffering servant is. But the Christian reading tells us that this suffering servant is Jesus, because here we have the portrayal of expiatory or vicarious suffering, that was the suffering which Jesus underwent on the cross. One thing is very sure, that is, this suffering servant has undergone unjust suffering, is humiliated, but still he feels the presence of God. The second reading is from the letter to the Hebrews, chapter 4, verses 14 to 16. The author of letter to the Hebrews presents Jesus as the supreme high priest. High priest of Judaism was alienated, distanced, was kept aloof from impurities of people, because he has to enter the Holy of Holies every year. But Jesus, on the other hand, through his mercy and compassion, embraces human vulnerabilities, temptations, and uncertainties. That's why the author of the letter says that with courage we can go near the throne of the high priest. The gospel reading is taken from Mark 10:35 to 45. Here, Jesus and the apostles are on the way to Jerusalem. Jerusalem was a significant place in the life of Jesus and in the life of apostles, because Jerusalem is the place where Jesus's life ends and Jesus's ascension happens. And from the point of view of the disciples, it is here that they begin their mission. Jesus predicts his passion thrice, and all the three times the disciples misunderstand him. When he foretold the first time, Peter said that suffering would not happen to Jesus. In the second time, the disciples were arguing on who is the greatest among them. Now, the apostles James and John argue or seek a place which is at the right and the left of Jesus. They seek places, one at right and another at left. The throne and the right and the left signified power centers. Actually, they are yielding to their basic power instinct. Jesus, in a way, invites them to participate in the cup of suffering and baptism by blood, and exhorts them saying that power lies in service. In the background of the synod, let us try to make sense of the word that we heard just now. The first lesson that we can learn is journeying together. Jesus, apostles, crowd, all three journey together to Jerusalem. If one were to be absent, the journey would be incomplete. Suppose journey is undertaken without Jesus, it will be a crowd based on mere ideology. Suppose apostles are absent, Jesus and crowd alone are present, then that would be like the crowd would tend to have Jesus for themselves. Leaving alone the crowd, Jesus and apostles will not make any church. So together, Jesus, apostles, crowd, all have a place and all walk hand in hand. There is no throne, there is no left or right place. So the first thing that we need to understand from the synod is that we need to journey together. Number two, synodality. Synodality means many hands joining together. It refers to synergy, that is multiplication of energy, dynamism, movement, and growth. In the first reading, we are able to see how the suffering servant joins hands with the people in undertaking suffering and humiliation, and already he proposes a life of synodality. In the second reading, Jesus, though a supreme high priest, enhances himself to the extent of embracing the humanity through his compassion, and thus Jesus initiates synodality. Number three, communion, participation, and mission. Communion through mercy, participation through suffering, and mission through reaching out. Today, as we begin the synod in our own dioceses, let us pray that the dream of the Holy Father comes true, that the church becomes a synodal church where we all journey together in synodality with communion, participation, and mission. God bless us. Thank you.